As you get a vulnerability management program underway, your first step is to develop requirements for that program. You'll think through whether the program is based upon a general desire to improve security, a response to regulatory requirements, or a reaction to corporate policy. Once you've done that, your next step is to turn those general requirements into a list of the specific systems and networks that you want to scan. In order to create this list, you need to have an asset inventory that you can trust. If your organization practices good asset management already, you may find that you already have this inventory ready to draw into your vulnerability management program. You might find that your organization's configuration management tools already have a complete inventory of systems and devices on your network, and, in the best case, that the inventory is kept up to date with information from regular network discovery scans. However, if you don't have this capability, you may instead turn to a scan run by your vulnerability management solution. Rather than running a full vulnerability scan, which can be very time-consuming, your system probably allows you to run a lightweight scan that just searches for systems on the local network. I'd like to show you how to set up a basic host discovery scan in Nessus. I'm just going to go ahead and click Host Discovery here, and then I'm going to give my scan a name. This is just arbitrary, anything that I'd like. I'll call it My Internal Network. And then I can provide the scan targets. And I'm going to use the private IP addresses of systems on this network, which is 172.31.0.0/16. Then I go ahead and click the Save button. And now here in Nessus, I have my new scan, and I can see that it hasn't yet been run. So I'm just going to hit this Launch button here to launch the scan. Now the scan will start and take a little while until it finishes. As the scan runs, it populates a list of the hosts that appear on the network. These are hosts that I could then scan for additional vulnerabilities using more advanced vulnerability scans. Other scanners may also provide you with a graphic view of network discovery results. For example, here's a network map created with the Qualys vulnerability scanner. Once you have a solid asset inventory, you'll need to begin prioritizing those assets for your scans. This is normally done by answering questions in three key areas about each asset. You'll want to know about the importance of the system in the overall scheme of things, summed up as the impact if a breach were to occur. To get at this, you'll want to be able to identify the highest level of data classification that's stored, processed, or transmitted by the system, device, or application. Clearly, you would want to assign a higher priority to systems that handle more sensitive information. Second, you'll want to know about the level of risk posed to the system based upon how exposed it is to an attacker. This is summed up as the likelihood of a successful attack. This first requires identifying the network exposure. Is the system addressable on the public internet? If it's behind a firewall, what rules exist to allow external access? You'll also want to know about what services the system exposes to the outside world. Is it a web server, DNS server, or a database server? How likely is it that an attacker will discover vulnerabilities in the services offered by the system? Finally, you'll want to know how critical the system is to your operations. Even if it doesn't contain sensitive information, a critical system might be very important in your vulnerability management program because business operations would be dramatically impacted if the system were not available. You'll definitely want to prioritize critical systems over their non-critical counterparts. Many organizations take the approach of scanning all of the systems, devices, and applications in their environment on a regular basis. That's absolutely fine, but it doesn't eliminate the need to perform an asset inventory and identify the criticality of different resources. Even if you're scanning everything, you're going to need a way to prioritize your remediation efforts, and the same criteria that you use to identify scanning targets are also quite helpful when planning remediation.